Good evening, this is Neil Spate in the first of a couple of calls this evening at some of the borough's beacons. And I'm here in Bulphan, where in the village hall, where the crowds are beginning to assemble for this evening's first lighting of a brand new beacon. And the story of the beacon and how it was brought together is told in an exhibition within the village hall. And it's been another fantastic community effort. Indeed, everything you tell you about Bulphan is community. It's one of those exemplary local villages where people come together and make things happen. And there's a wonderful exhibition here of memories from the village. There's the story of the death of King George VI and homes and buildings in Thurrock. And indeed memories of past jubilees that have taken place here. And this exhibition is open all throughout the weekend, so I'm sure I'll put a link onto the story. And the village is very proud of its history, so you can come along and look at this. Of course, the rather wonderful church that they have here in Bulphan, and lots more memories. Of course, a raffle that's taking place. And again, more memories, really wonderful. And did those feet in ancient time walk upon... I won't sing, no, that's too much. Bulphan Women's Institute, great organisation, regularly featured on Thurrock Nub News with all their reports. And indeed, many stories and pictures will no doubt be evoked by these, or memories rather, will be evoked by these pictures of Bulphan School. So, as I say, people are starting to gather for the evening's celebrations. One of the leading figures in the local community, very well-known lady, and decked out absolutely appropriately, is Janet McShane. A lot of planning gone into this evening.
A lot of planning, yes, but it's amazing how it's all coming together, how all the villagers are helping. Got a great team behind me.
And you had an event this afternoon?
We did. We had the town crier, Steve Finn, declaiming the proclamation. That was very successful.
Yeah, good. And this evening you've got a piper, Joe the Piper, who we've featured before on Dub News.
She'll be up here.
She'll be performing.
She will.
And then you're lighting the beacon, what, about 9:45? Something
yes.
like that.
In between we've got the rector saying the set prayer for the day and saying a few thank yous.
And just tell me a little bit about the beacon. It's new. It must have been a lot of effort to get it together.
It's new in a way, but the actual post is from Chatham Docks, recycled green heart oak, which is the very hard wood that Shackleton had for his ships because they go through ice, so it should be quite hardy. And the brazier is new, made by Alan Theobald, a local blacksmith. David. Alan was his dad, so sorry.
That's all right. So some in there for generations to come, they'll no doubt be holding celebrations here. So I'm going to wander out and have a look. Thank you very much for explaining what's going on. And well done to you and all your volunteers for keeping this community going. It's a really wonderful community.
Thank you.
We'll just have a wander out as people continue to arrive. There'll be all sorts of things happening in the village over the weekend. There's a bunting competition. And I think people in the village, if you haven't already, you've still got time to get your bunting out. And we'll come to the recreation ground where people are already gathering around the rather wonderful new beacon, which sits proudly ready to be illuminated after the sun has set on what has been a truly memorable day. It's been a great fun whizzing all around South Essex and seeing lots of people enjoying themselves. And I dare say that I'll be out and about on Friday, Saturday and Sunday, making the most of recording all these things for posterity, which I think is really important. And it's been really interesting talking to people who remembered previous jubilees, just as Janet was saying there, and we saw on those pictures on the wall. These are things that people remember for a lifetime. So we'll just approach the new beacon. As I say, in about an hour, it will be shining brightly. But we'll move on to somewhere else in the borough and actually see one lit. But really rather lovely. And as I say, well done to everybody concerned here in Bulphan. Good evening. And as the sun sets, Thurrock Nub News at the end of a long day finds itself down at Coalhouse Fort, where we've just had a beautiful rendition of some fantastic tunes from the Tilbury Band. And we now, as you can see, lots and lots of people here gathered around the lake.
I declare before you all, my whole life,
Local councillor Fraser Massey making a speech.
A Queen's kept a word, a rebel would touch a fool. So here we are, celebrating 70 years of undignified and beautiful service. A true celebration of a monarch's pledge decades ago. And with that, with you all joined with me, and from East Tilbury, can we all give 3 cheers for the Queen? Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
God save the Queen. Have a great night. Thank you.
Hundreds of people down here at Coalhouse. Which is one of the most picturesque settings. And just down the river at Tilbury Fort, there's a beacon also being lit. And further down the river, one at Purfleet, which we visited earlier. The village of Fobbin has a beacon, and as those of you may have seen just a few minutes ago, Bulphan will also be getting ready with its beacon. As are, I think, more than 3,000 beacons across the country. Over the fort. The beacon is being lit by Ken Levy, a stalwart of Coalhouse Fort for many years. quite sure what the delay is, but I'm sure it will be happening soon. Appear to be a huge amount of activity at the beacon, but there's a man in a high-vis jacket. You just caught a glimpse there of the iconic radar tower on the river, which runs around Coalhouse. Well, they've waited 70 years, what's a few more minutes? The crowd have got their spirits up with a bit of Sweet Caroline. I think what the delay may be, that I think they're aiming to do this bang on 9:45 along the lighting time of all the other beacons. Soon tick down. A rousing rendition of the national anthem.